Here we focus on subtraction for mixed fractions. In some cases, it's going to be easier for us if we convert them into improper fractions. In some cases, it's not. And then in some cases, we're going to be kind of decomposing them in other ways in order to make it a little bit easier to perform the operations. So let's focus on this first one again. So when we have 3.5 minus 1 2/3. Again, visually we can think of what this means. We've got 3 wholes and we've got 1/2, so that one's not there. And then we're subtracting 1 2/3 here. And so in this case, we know that at least, you know, these two are gonna cancel each other out, and since this is a little bit bigger than 1/2, it's going to eat into one of these other ones. So we're going to be looking at 1 and something else as our final answer. Now, if it were a different case, so say instead of 2/3, we just had like 1/3 here, and so we just had this part here. In this case, it would be much easier to do this problem without worrying about improper fractions, because we just have the 3 minus the 1, and then so that'd be 2, so it leaves us with those two there. And then we can do the 1/2 minus 1/3, so we have 1/2 minus 1/3, and you might recall that that should give us, you know, if we convert 1/2, that's 3/6, and then 1/3 is 2/6, so all up we'd be doing 3 minus 2 gives us 1/6, and so we just have a 6 left over. Unfortunately, that's not the case, so in our case we actually do need to do a little bit of conversion into improper fractions. So the way that we usually set this up is we'll say, okay, it's not going to be a straightforward one where I can just subtract the fractional parts and the whole number parts separately, so I convert the 3.5 into halves, and I do this by multiplying 3 by 2 to give me 6. Why do I multiply it by 2? Because I know that in 3, for every whole, there's 2 halves. And so I've got 6 halves all up there, and then my other half is there. So I've got 7 halves all up. So this is 7 on 2. And then 1 2/3, I do 1 times 3 and then add it to 2. So 1 times 3 is 3. And again, because in a whole, I've got 3/3, so I've got those 3/3 for my whole, and then plus 2. So I've got minus 5/3. Now, once I'm here, I can't subtract thirds from halves, so I need to have a common denominator. This is going to be 6. Whoa. So the lowest common multiple of 2 and 3 equals 6. So to convert halves to 6, I multiply top and bottom by 3 to get an equivalent fraction where halves are the denominator. And for 5 and 3, I multiply by 2 so that I get those in terms of 6 as well. So then I'll have 21 on 6 minus 10 on 6 to get 11/6 all up. And because my question was posed as a mixed number, it's usually just a polite formality to respond in a mixed number as well. So 11/6 is the same as 1 with 5 left over, so 1 and 5/6 all up. Now, so let's go through in our next question, because in this case, we'll see that sometimes the conversion to improper fractions is not always that useful. Or it's useful. I mean, you can always do it, but sometimes there's an easier way. So here, we've got 5 2/7 minus 4 3/5. Now again, if we just think a little bit about what's going on here, we've got 5 wholes and then 2/7, so some fractional part there. And then we've got minus 4. And our 3/5, we should be able to, just from estimation, see that that's going to be slightly bigger than that part there. So we're going to have these bits all cancelling. And then when we subtract this, it's going to eat a little bit out of that top one there. Okay. Now, If I do what I did before, though, and convert it into improper fractions, I'm going to have 5 times 7 gives me, there's 35 sevenths plus 2 on 7, minus 4 times 5 is 20, 23 on 5. And so all up, I have 37 on 7, minus 23 on 5. And I have to get into common denominator. So again, lowest common multiple of 7 and 5 is actually 35. So I have to multiply here by 5, multiply here by 7. So I can see that they're going to be quite big numbers. And so in that case, I mean, we can do it, and there's ways of doing it. And even since we're multiplying by 5, it's not too hard. But we can actually make this process a little bit easier by instead just decomposing our number a little bit. So let's do it instead this way. So I'm going to get rid of all this because I'm too lazy to want to have to multiply 37 times 5 and 23 times 7. So instead, I approach this by saying, again, it might help us. Remember what happened when I drew it out? So that's 5, and then I've got some little fractional bit, and then I've got 4, and it's got a fractional bit as well. And I know that when I subtract 4, so these will cancel out. And so really, my problem is the same as, it's actually just the same as subtracting 1 and my fractional bit minus that other fractional bit. So essentially, deal with that whole number part first. So I have 5 minus 4 equals 1. So I get 1 and 2 sevenths minus 3 fifths. So I essentially simplify this problem down, because now when I convert it into mixed numbers, I'm just going to have 9 sevenths minus 3 fifths. I'm going to still convert it into 30 fifths, but now I only have to multiply 9 times 5 and 3 times 7. So it's going to be just so much easier. So I get 9 times 5 is 45 on 7 minus... Sorry, on 35. Minus 21 on 35, which all up will give me 24 on 35. And I know that because 35 is 5 times 7, and 5 and 7, neither of those go into 24, that this is going to be my fraction in its simplest form. So 24 35ths. And so, you know, sometimes if we think about the problem in a slightly different way, it'll just save us from some of the difficulties that can arise otherwise. Okay, let's do this last one. So in this case, the way that I would probably, you know, start to approach these in the simplest way possible. First, subtract the whole number part if we can. So this will leave us with 1 and 8 ninths minus a sixth. Convert it into improper fractions. So this is going to be 1 times 9 is 9, so 17 on 9 minus 1 on 6. Convert it into, now converting it into common denominator. So the lowest common multiple of 9 and 6 is actually 18. So this is a case where the lowest common multiple is not just 9 times 6. The way that we can work it out is either just by thinking of the multiples, so 9, 18, 27, etc. And for 6, we've got 6, 12, 18. So we get that as lowest common multiple. Or you might recall, if we break them down into their... their prime factorization, we've got 3 times 3 and 2 times 3, and so the smallest number that has all of that in it is 2 times 3 times 3. So it's got the 3 times 3 from here, and it's got the 2 times 3 from there. So that gives us our 18. So here we're just going to be multiplying by 2, here we multiply by 3, and so we can get our equivalent fractions, which is 34 on 18 minus 3 on 18 equals 31 on 18, which gives us 1 and 13 left over. Okay. Now, again, for this last one, maybe a slight shortcut that we could have done in the end, if we recognize that a sixth, is less than 8/9, then I don't really need to worry about converting it into an improper fraction first, because I'm not going to need to borrow from that whole in order to subtract. Again, drawing it diagrammatically, we've got, you know, 2 plus most of a third whole, and then we've got 1 and a sixth, and so let's make it 1 and a sixth, and so I can see that those will cancel out, and then this will only need to borrow from that one there. So I'm going to be left with at least this whole here. Okay, so recapping for addition and subtraction. With addition, the only time we need to convert between improper fractions and whole numbers is at the end in order to simplify. It doesn't help us with addition to convert our numbers into improper fractions. With subtraction, we often do need to convert into improper fractions, but we don't need to convert the whole number into improper fractions. We can usually subtract the whole number first, and then perhaps use, if our second fraction is bigger than our other one, then we can just use one whole or whatnot. As an example, sorry, kept on that point. So say for instance we had, 5 and a tenth, and I'm subtracting, just say 2 3/4, something like this. Now, again, I can simplify by first doing the whole numbers, so 3 1/10, this becomes 3 1/10 minus 3/4. But here, I don't need to convert all the 3. So remember, I've got 3 wholes here, and a little bit of a tenth, a little bit there, and then I'm just subtracting 3/4. I'm just subtracting this much. There's no need to convert these wholes into tenths as well. I can just leave them as they are, and then just convert this one into tenths. So I could actually make this equivalent to 2 and convert one of them into tenths, so 2 11/10 minus 3/4, and then just deal with this part separately here. So I've just converted one of the wholes into tenths rather than doing a whole improper fraction. So sometimes, it doesn't make it wrong to convert the whole thing, it just might save us some arithmetical difficulty. Okay, I hope that is helpful. Next, we'll look at multiplication and division.